guys, and welcome back to my channel. So today's video is going to be just what the thumbnail says. It's going to be a sustainable Christmas gift guide. December and Christmas in general is such a wasteful time of the year, so I think there's great reason to really reconsider the way that you gift gifts to people, and just in general think about your waste this time of year. So along with giving you some tips on sustainably and ethically made Christmas gifts, I'm also going to be sharing some tips and some things that I'm going to be trying out myself personally by the end of this video to try and have a more low waste Christmas this year. Today's video is a paid collaboration together with Everlane, so we're providing you with a little gift guide together this time, and I'm super excited about that. You guys know that I love Everlane. I have loved this brand for years. So they've kindly gifted me a few items for this video, but I'm also gonna be including just some other things they have on their shop right now that I've just been eyeing out and that I feel are great ideas for a Christmas present for someone that you love, and maybe just yourself if you want to spoil yourself. So I have a few pieces here which I would categorize as luxurious Christmas gifts, and really something you can spoil someone with, something that they can love for many years. And again, it's a huge plus that these items are all ethically made as well. So let's have a look at the first item that I wanted to include in today's video. Absolutely love this set, and I think that you guys are gonna love it too. So it is a silk sleep set or a pajama from Everlane in this lovely gray color. I am so in love with this set, and it is so incredibly soft. I love the color. It matches that gray wall that we just made in our bedroom perfectly, actually, so it couldn't be a better match. But it's just, like I said, incredibly soft, and I feel so special when I wear this. It's the perfect Christmas gift, I would say. I'm the type of person who sleeps in like old like joggers and things like that, and there's nothing wrong with that. I feel really comfortable in that clothing, and you know, it's really cozy, and it's a, you know, great sustainable way to look at sleepwear, really, to downgrade your own clothing that you don't use anymore, then use it for other purposes like that. But this just makes me feel, like I said, so special, and I feel like kind of dressed up, but at the same time I'm super comfortable. We're gonna spend Christmas with my husband's family this year, and I can't wait to bring this set with me. I'm gonna be lounging around in the house watching Christmas movies, drinking coffee, and just having a good time in this amazing sleep set. This is also available in like a pale pink, and I was actually really in doubt whether I wanted to choose this gray set or if I wanted to choose the pink set, because I think they're both super cute. But we all know me, I love my neutrals. I love gray, black, white, so I of course had to go for the gray one. So the next item that I wanted to include in this gift guide is more kind of like a practical item, and it's actually something that I feel like I've been missing myself personally for a really long time. If you watch my guide on how to be practical, like dress practical but look chic at the same time, you might remember me mentioning something about a bag that was chic but practical. And this is exactly what this bag is. This is the Renew Tote from Everlane, so it's made from recycled materials, it's made from recycled plastic. Absolutely love this bag. It's huge too, like look at the size of it. So it has the size of a, like a proper everyday shopper, which is like one of my must-have bags in my wardrobe. When I go to work, when I go down to my office downtown, or if I'm out shopping, things like that, if I'm riding my bike all around town, this is the size of bag I need to just like pop all of my stuff down into. And the great thing about this is that it's super practical because it's made in this nylon fabric, so it is actually water repellent, which I think is amazing. That video I mentioned before, I mentioned something about missing a bag that was cute, but that will still repel the rain when I'm out and about, and this bag is gonna do just that for me. So I would say this is the perfect gift for anyone who rides their bike a lot, or who just like runs all over town a lot and often has to like face all sorts of weather. And this is gonna be a must for me when I take my bike down to my office downtown, especially through those like drizzly winter days. This is gonna be a lifesaver. So they have it in a few other different colors on their webshop, but I obviously had to go for the black one because I just love black. So the next item that I picked out for this Christmas gift guide is a pair of jeans. And the reason why I wanted to mention these pair of jeans is actually because Avalanche is one of my absolute favorite denim brands. I feel like their jeans fit amazingly well, they wash really well, they don't lose their shape or anything like that. They just make amazing jeans. And that's why I wanted to include a pair of jeans in this video. It might be a bit hard to gift someone a pair of jeans actually, so in that case I would probably gift a gift card instead, because then, you know, people can choose the right size themselves. There's a whole measurement chart on Avalanche's website. I'd also recommend you to always read the product description, because some fits, you know, you need to maybe size down one size or size up one size depending on the fit you want. And also you can always contact their customer service if you're in doubt with your size, because obviously purchasing jeans online can be a bit tricky. So do all of your research, do what you can to make sure that you order the right size, basically. So Avalanche is definitely a great place to look for. They make their jeans on one of the cleanest denim factories in the world, with a lot of like reduced waste and things like that. And yeah, like I said, I just feel like their jeans last really well at the same time, so that's pretty cool. So the jeans that I picked out are the Cheeky jean in like a straight fit. This is the sky blue color, and I love this color. It's sort of like a vintage wash. I feel like this light blue color is a must for me in my wardrobe. It goes with everything I have in my wardrobe, and they just fit so well. I actually chose them in a regular length because most of the jeans that I have in my own wardrobe are actually cropped, and I kind of like the look of a pair of jeans like covering up your boots. I think that gives sort of like a great 90s vibe to your whole outfit. So that's why I thought I wanted to try a regular length jean. These have a tiny bit of stretch to them, only 2%, so not too much. I'm not a huge fan of like jeggings. I like when they're like proper denim, but they do have a little bit of stretch to them, which just makes them super comfortable because they're also super high-waisted. So it's nice that they're nice and stretchy around the tummy area. So along with these three items that I picked out for this video, I just wanted to quickly mention some other items that I find quite suitable for like Christmas presents as well. Obviously, like I mentioned, Avalanche also sell like gift cards online, so you can always give someone special a gift card for their webshop. So obviously gifting a Christmas gift card is a clever solution, because then the person that you're giving this gift card to can choose for themselves what they feel like they need, really. Another item that I find quite suitable for a special Christmas gift is maybe gifting one of their amazing Renew knitwear. So these are jumpers, like knitwear made in recycled materials. Actually, this cardigan that I'm wearing today was also a gift from Avalanche, and it's made in recycled cashmere, which is amazing. I've been loving this cardigan so much, and I feel like there's just something about gifting jumpers that are insanely like Christmassy. And also I just find it so amazing that Avalanche are delving more and more into using recycled materials. That's something I feel like it's a huge step for them as a brand, and yeah, it's just a great thing to support, I think. So those are the items from Avalanche that I find suitable for gifting this Christmas, or something that I would be happy to receive myself this Christmas. So this next part of the video is going to be more about how to have a low-waist Christmas, and these are all things that I'm gonna try out myself as well. I could easily list up a whole list with tips on how to have a low-waist Christmas, but I've picked out 5 different areas where I'm definitely gonna do like an effort myself this year, and not just mention a whole lot of things you can do. Like, this is actually something I'm gonna try to do myself this year. So the first thing I'm gonna try to do this year to have a more low-waist and eco-friendly Christmas is to cook vegan Christmas foods. I have a fellow Danish eco-friendly influencer to thank for the inspiration for this. This is actually her recipe, and I cannot wait to try it because it looks insanely good. It is Gitte Mary, who is like a zero waste influencer from Denmark. You might remember that I actually did some content with her a couple of years back. We met up and did a vlog together, chatted all things zero waste. So yeah, she shared this recipe on her blog the other day, and I just knew immediately that I have to try this. So it's sort of like a Danish traditional Christmas dish. but just made vegan. So it's like it looks like a traditional meatloaf with like some pastry on top. Then there's some red cabbage, some potatoes, and some other things. And also the dessert is risalamande, which is super Danish. It might sound a little bit French, but it's super Danish. Not sure that I'm gonna succeed making it 100% vegan, but I'm definitely gonna cut out the meat this year. Like, this is what I'm gonna try to do this year. Another thing that I really want to do this year is to invest in a happy tree. I've mentioned this before on my channel, I think I might have mentioned it in my sustainable gift guide last year or just at some point throughout December last year. Up until now, we've been buying like real Christmas trees every single year, but I realized that this is not necessarily very sustainable because many Christmas trees are obviously mass produced, and in the whole production and growing of these trees, there's a lot of harsh fertilizers and things like that used in the whole process, which is just not very eco-friendly. So my solution to this is to invest in a so-called happy tree. This is an award-winning design. I'm actually pretty sure they're Danish too. So it is all sustainably made. It's like this super cute, very simple and minimal kind of wooden Christmas tree that you can then spice up with baubles and other kind of decor. You can go out into the woods and collect some twigs and some pine cones to put onto the tree yourself to make it look more like a real Christmas tree, basically. But I just find them so cute. I find this to be such a, like, again, cute. I feel like I say that all the time. Like a cute, very Nordic way of dealing with Christmas trees in a more sustainable way. So I'm so in love with the design of these trees. They're quite pricey depending on the height you want of the tree, and knowing me, I'd like to have a tree that looks like the real deal. So at least, I think it's 125 or 180 centimeters tall. You can also get them way smaller. But if you think about how much money you spend on buying a single Christmas tree, like a real tree, every single year, then you will earn those money back at some point. And yeah, it's just also a more sustainable choice than choosing a plastic tree, because obviously a plastic tree is also reusable, but not everyone agrees that it's a very sustainable choice in terms of, like, you know, some of the materials that are used to make these trees, plastic to mention one. So I would definitely say going for a wooden one is a better option. It's also way better than the plastic one. I also think it's way cuter. Also wanted to mention the whole gift wrap thing, which is something that I'm thinking about a lot myself. I have this huge roll of gift wrap that I've had for years. I think I've had it for like 6 or 7 years, and I got it when I had my very first job working as a design assistant for a Danish women's wear brand, and we had like this office declutter at some point, and we had these rolls with, you know, rolls that they use in shops to wrap Christmas presents with, so these like huge giant rolls with Christmas wrap, and I was actually allowed to take a couple of these home with me. So I kept one for myself, and then I gave my sister the other one, and I still have that roll of gift wrap. I even use it for like birthday presents and things like that, and it's kind of like an ongoing joke in our family that we've just been using this same gift wrap for the past many years because it just never seems to end. But it's just like plain white gift wrap with like some structure in it. And I really want to use up that one before I go out and buy any gift wrap. And I haven't had to buy any gift wrap for the past 7 years almost because I still have that huge roll. But yeah, what I wanted to say about gift wrap is, of course, you need to reconsider what you buy there as well. If I had to go out and buy Christmas gift wrap, if I run out at some point, maybe in a couple of years, I will definitely stay away from anything that has glitters in it, unless I know that it's sustainable and reusable in some way, because glitters are obviously made of plastic. So anything shiny and glittery, which, you know, is what people often buy throughout Christmas, is not a very sustainable choice because you actually cannot reuse or recycle that kind of gift wrap. So going to something that is either made from recycled paper or something that is FSC certified or something like that is a lot more sustainable. Obviously, you could also use like old cloths or pieces of fabric. Maybe you have like some bed sheets that you can cut up or something like that. Maybe go thrift hunting. Also, this past year, I have been saving gift wrap and like tissue paper more than ever. Some of you might remember my big paper bag that I've had on my floor for years, like in front of my mirror where I take my daily outfit pictures. I have two of those, and in one of them, I keep all of my gift wrap And I've just been keeping all sorts of different like packaging and tissue paper for the past year and a half or so, just because it's nice to be able to reuse it. And whenever I need to wrap a present, I always have something in stock because I just reuse everything. Like when I get something in the mail and I find it suitable for gift wrapping, I just save it so I can reuse it some other time. The final thing that I wanted to mention today is obviously it's amazing to receive a gift if it's something that you've been missing, like a thing you've been missing in your life or something like that. But it's also pretty amazing to give someone an experience that you can share together, or like give someone a service, like something they need help to do or something like that. A couple of years ago, my sister and I actually gave my mom like a whole day of cleaning her entire apartment. So we cleaned it from top to bottom and it was just spick and span, and it made her very, very happy. It feels amazing for you who are giving the present, but it certainly also feels amazing for the people receiving a gift like that. And also, experiences is something that I always speak highly about. My husband and I have been giving each other experiences all throughout this year for like birthdays and anniversaries and things like that. So we got to go to concerts together, to the spa, or we also took a coffee course together. That was something he gave me for my birthday. So like a barista course, which was something I would never have thought about myself, but it was just such a fun experience. It was something we had never tried before. So it was lovely to share that experience together. So in general, gifting non-materialistic things are definitely also something that is super sustainable, but it's also just something that can bring you closer to the people that you love. So that is it for today's video, guys. I really hope that you enjoyed it, and I hope it gave you some inspiration on not only having a more low-waste Christmas, but also gave you some inspiration for lovely Christmas gifts. Huge thank you to Everlane for sponsoring this video and for working with me. One more time, it's always a pleasure. I'm really starting to get in the mood for Christmas now. Like, I'm really starting to look forward to Christmas and really dig into that whole Christmas spirit. I can't wait to find my Christmas decor and start pimping up the house. Also cannot wait to do Vlogmas. So I think I'm gonna be taking you guys along with me to some of like the local Christmas markets here in Denmark. Also maybe gonna go to Flensburg, check out their Christmas market as well. So thank you guys so much for watching. Don't forget to give me a like and subscribe to my channel before you leave. And then I will see you all in my next video. Bye guys.